All right, thanks, Allison. So as Allison just showed you, those storms kind of moving on out, and they were certainly felt earlier on Sanibel Island. We're going to continue our team coverage with NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis. She's live on Sanibel Beach tonight. Jacqueline, it was a little rough there for a while.
It was. I was supposed to be out here at 5 o'clock. The lightning was so close to us at 5 o'clock. It just wasn't even safe to get out of our cars. We stayed in the car during that time at the request of the meteorologist, who said that lightning is right on top of you. It was rainy and stormy. It's still a little misty almost out here, but nothing as serious as we were seeing. Let's take a look at what it looked like during that storm. We'll start with some video from the top of our live truck. This is from our mass camera. You can see those dark clouds rolling on to Sanibel Island, rolling in from the Gulf. It rained for a good 20 minutes, really steady. And then we started seeing a lot more of that lightning and hearing that thunder. The second round of today's rain, kind of similar to the first round that we saw. A big concern out here on Sanibel Island, of course, is beach erosion. City staff actually watched specific sections of the beach to ensure that there were no erosion issues, especially on Sanibel Captiva Road. So far, we have not seen any drastic issues or major concerns from today's storm. Now, like I said, it is a little bit rainy still. It's not stopping everyone. There are people out here on the beach searching for those shells. Of course, those storms can sometimes bring in some interesting shells from the Gulf of Mexico. It is clearing up a bit, but the rain is still here, and it definitely got a lot cooler. I know Allison mentioned that as well. Reporting live on Sanibel Island, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.
The city of Sanibel actually just sent out an email alert giving the all clear. I guess they want people to resume their Friday night plans, go out to dinner, or collect shells. Good point there, Jacqueline. Here's a live look right now at the Cape Coral Yacht Club. It's calming down there as well, but this is probably bad news for the water. The health department just put out some signs on the beach there yesterday, alerting people not to go in the water because of high levels of bacteria. Well, all of this storm runoff is probably only going to make that worse. So again, this is a live picture right now at the Cape Coral Yacht Club.